Hey everyone, today I bring you an unboxing, installation and benchmarking video of a used NVIDIA RTX 3090 Founders Edition graphics card. I bought it a few months ago for 48,000 rupees. At that time, a brand new RTX 3070 was selling at nearly 52,000 rupees. And because of the terrible price at which the RTX 4070 launched, I decided to go ahead with this one. Of course, I stress tested this at the shop before bringing it home. I checked the VRAM temperatures, core clock speeds, fan speeds, and benchmarking results. When I saw the card's dusty condition, it was pretty obvious that it was used for mining before. It had sticky dust accumulated in its fin stacks, most likely because it was being used in an open bench and placed near a desert cooler. I had to deep clean it after bringing it home with a keyboard cleaning brush and an air blower. I regretted unscrewing the backside GPU fan as I accidentally removed its ribbon cable too. Inserting back that ribbon cable became a very stressful task, and I would highly recommend that you leave the fans as is if you bought a GPU in such a condition. Just try to clean it as much as you can without taking it apart. If you wish to know the model number of the two GPU cooler fans or of the full specs of my computer or any other details that I missed telling you here, please refer to the video description. I bought this card primarily for editing videos and game on it in my free time. I have upgraded from a 7-year-old Sapphire RX 460 2GB DDR5 graphics card. It doesn't really make sense to compare these two GPUs, but I did it anyway. In the game's graphic settings, I tried to choke the RTX 3090 as much as I could, but for the RX 460, I had to dial back the graphics a lot to get some playable FPS out of it. For video editing, I'm switching from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve Studio. You may already know that Resolve Studio takes full advantage of all available GPU horsepower in the system. At the time of making this video, I'm still learning it, and hence you won't find any Resolve Studio benchmark in this video. But in the Adobe Premiere Pro testing, I used the Laptop RAM Upgrade video project that I uploaded to YouTube some time ago. So you can check that video from the I button above if you want. With the amount of time this GPU saves, it feels like a good investment for the coming 5 years. By the way, this GPU increased total power consumption of my computer by almost 200%. Also, after a few months, I started facing some RAM instability issue with the system, but during these benchmarks, I had DOCP enabled and my RAM sticks were running at 3600 MHz speed and 19/20/20/40 timings. But now I am running them at 3133 MHz speed with the same timings. I can only blame my ASUS board for that. Because when I turn on the DOCP in BIOS, I receive a warning that PCIe 4.0 devices can cause instability with SoC overclocks. Not that I'm not doing any overclocks on my CPU, and I have no clue what DOCP does to my CPU. So yeah, that's all for this video. Like it if you liked it, dislike it if you disliked it, leave your comments down below, and consider subscribing if you wish to see more content from me. Feel free to check my previous uploads. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.